I'm going to show you how to get rid of a distraction in a photo using Photoshop using an option that not a lot of people are aware of. Here's a photo I shot 2 days ago of this duck, and it's a great photograph, but I want to get rid of this in the background and kind of make it look uniform. So let's go ahead and make a selection around that area first. Now, a best practice would be to duplicate that layer, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to make a selection using the lasso tool. And let's get that little bit there. Make sure we cover the wing area. Then we're getting all of that. There we go. Now I could fill it with black, but if you notice there's a subtle grass pattern, I want to make sure it matches. So this is as simple as using content aware fill, but we're going to have one little challenge and we'll look at this. So we're going to use the shift delete key. That would be the shift backspace on Windows to open up the fill dialog box. Now under contents, choose content aware, color adaptation on, and just leave it at the default settings, and then click OK. Now, generally speaking, we're going to get a pretty good option. Okay, maybe not so good this time. We got some wings and stuff in there. Let's try that again. Shift backspace, and we'll apply it a second time. And we'll see how we go. Nope, we still got the wings in there, and we've got these little spots here from the water droplets. Okay, so what do we do in this situation? Let me show you a great option. So rather than just applying the content aware fill with the fill dialog, we're going to go up under the edit menu. Then under Edit, go down to Content Aware Fill. Now you're going to see this dialog box. And what this dialog box is doing is giving us a visual representation of what's happening. Here's our area that's being filled. Here's our area that it's sampling from. The area is in green, and you can see that's the result. Okay, so it's as simple as staying in the auto mode. If you don't see that, just click on auto. And then I'm just going to paint with auto on. I'm going to select over this duck, release it, and watch in this preview. Notice that that duck disappears. It's not going to change in our main window. We need to focus on this preview. We've still got these little spots. So to get rid of the spots, all we need to do is just paint these out using the same option. That means that they will not be sampled. And let's watch those spots in here. Mostly disappeared. There's still a few there, which means that I've just got to go in here and just make sure I get rid of all of these or close to it. Let's see if this updates. Good enough. Look at that. There's a couple that we can get rid of easier than going over everything. But as you notice, this is looking a lot better. And all we're going to do is just click OK to apply it. And as you can see, Control D will turn off the selection. Now we've got a few little spots there. So easy to fix with the spot healing. So let's go under our patch tool here or under the healing brush, choose the spot healing brush, and we just simply just tap on these little dots to make them disappear. And as simply as that, we've healed this photograph, got rid of those distractions, cleaned up that background. Let me know in the comments underneath if you knew about this or if anything is new. So if you're new or you've been watching and you haven't yet hit the subscribe button, now is the time. Hit that subscribe button. Ring that bell and you won't miss any of my weekly tutorials. And do me a favor, if you like this, hit that like button, smash it into dust. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.